For those of you who watched my last upload about this fantastic chateau in France, well, you know, you remember how desperate I was to see inside. I had all sorts of fantasies about how it would be inside their time capsule. Well, we're in absolute luck because a few of my viewers directed me to a video on this channel exploring the Unbeaten path, and he and his team of young explorers had actually been inside the chateau. So I was most intrigued. I checked out the video. Fantastic. And I thought, what do I do? Do I head all the way down there to France again to try and get in and avoid the squirrel man? Or I could just try writing an email to the owner of the channel and ask permission to use the footage from the video. And I got in contact with Bob from Exploring the Unbeaten Path here. So kind, really top guy, nice guy. I asked him for permission and he immediately gave it. I said, of course, I'd credit his channel, which I'm doing now. Thank you so much, Bob. I owe you one, mate. I definitely owe you a favor. Thanks a lot for that. Go and check out Bob's channel. Doing really well for an urban explorer. 164,000 subscribers he's got. Fantastic. And let's check his about section. For 12 years, we visit the coolest abandoned buildings in Europe, Asia, Africa, and the US and experience crazy adventures. After the TV series Exodus, which was broadcasted in Belgium and the Netherlands in 2016, we decided to make our own channel. Great stuff. So they've been on TV. Check their channel out. And I'm really, really grateful that they have given us the chance to explore inside the Enchanted Chateau. Fantastic stuff. Thank you, Bob. Of course, I was most curious as to how they got in the chateau. I couldn't see an immediate way of entry. They had got in through the rear, the other side. And if you can see here now, this is the rear, how overgrown it was. Although they only uploaded the video a few months ago, from the comments that they made during the exploration, they had been in here more than a year ago. Since then, the back is like woodland, it's overgrown. I did say to Oddie, I thought I could get in from where the farmer's field was and the squirrel man would not be able to see me there. But yeah, I'm getting a bit too old to be arrested and climb up drain pipes and through windows and such. So we didn't attempt it, but these guys did. So without any further ado, let's join them on their explore. So you see they're coming in from the other side. I was where that hedge is, where that young man's head is. We were looking in from that side, and I said to Oddie, over the other side, we could possibly get in through the farmer's field, but it was so overgrown, and yeah, we're getting a bit too old to be climbing drain pipes and climbing through windows, and we didn't want to get arrested, so we didn't attempt it, but these guys did. I'm happy to see that. It's not the time capsule that I imagined, my dear viewers. Unfortunately, the place is in a serious state of ruin. Very sad to see. Quite broke my heart. I was really imagining it inside to be a perfect time capsule. Not the case. So, as we can see, it turns out from reading the comments under Bob's video that some of the people who live in that town said that the lady is in an old people's home now, and she had lived here until quite recently, possibly a year ago. I thought it was closed for years. I never saw inside, of course, that she had lived here, and she was obviously a hoarder, a messy. Wait till you see this place. I mean, I'm not even sure whether it could be saved now. There is so much devastation. The roof has caved in many parts. If it could be restored, it's going to cost a lot of money, and I think it's such a shame. Such a shame that the French government don't take an interest in these chateaus outside of Paris. They've survived so much. They've survived wars. They've survived fire and floods. It's a shame to me that this is going to be lost to history. A real shame. But look at the mess inside. One of my viewers imagined an 18th century vampire wandering through the halls. I love that. Or vampirus wandering through the halls. I really like that imagination. Yeah, I could imagine that, but not now when I see this. Oh my goodness. Still a lot of original stuff in there from the time that it was opened, when it was built, I should say. And look at the beautiful fireplace to the left there. Wonderful. The stuffed animals, the taxidermy specimens, have seen better days. They are mildewed and moth-eaten and mite-bitten. Yeah. But I wish I could have joined them on this explore. Nonetheless, there's the front door. You remember the front door when I filmed from the outside, looking firmly shut and mysterious? Well, they're inside there. Look at that. Oh my goodness, yeah. So obviously a lot of damp, and this probably hasn't been heated, I would say, in a long time. I don't know how this old woman survived. I don't even know if she's one of the relatives of the people who owned this chateau originally. No idea. I'd love to know more. But, yeah. You know, this place could be opened as a bed and breakfast. I don't think it would bring in much money as a sort of museum open to the public. But if they were to restore it and open it as a bed and breakfast, I'm sure that could return the money invested in it. It really deserved to be saved because the outside is phenomenal and the inside could be again. There's a lot of original stuff here, a lot of original features. Obviously, the upstairs has suffered more than downstairs, as you will soon see. And look, he's uncovering there with his foot the beautiful mosaic-tiled floor. Ah, I'm just trying to imagine how this place must have looked when it was first built. Absolutely gorgeous. If I had a time machine, I'd be scooting back there. Scooting back there with my top hat on, knocking at the door, telling them I'm a travelling salesman and I've got the first electric vacuum back in 1840. Oh my God, I'm talking rubbish. So here we're going up to either the first or second floor, depending on what country you're in. And here's me wondering. I was standing outside for an hour, wondering what it looked like inside. Yeah, I'm sort of half glad I know. Yeah, it is a bit sad. It is a bit, it's more than a bit sad, it's a lot sad. So these guys managed to get past the squirrel man. I don't know, he might have been out gathering nuts that day. And he didn't see them. Look, there the roof. He's pointing there where the roof has totally fallen through. And look, how did she... I mean, she must have spent years pulling all this stuff in. Like a bower bird. And just pulling rubbish in too. Nothing, you know. Oh my goodness. I don't know. Maybe it's obviously a mental illness. She must have felt this like sort of some security from the outside world. Maybe people had tried to break in, intruders. She had security cameras throughout when the electricity was working. Poor old dear. Old pool table or billiard of some kind. There's a beautiful old chair there with carved initials. I'm wondering whether that's part of the family belongings, the initials. I don't know. Maybe somebody can enlighten me. I mean, it's a huge place, isn't it? Absolutely huge. Cost a fortune to heat. Yeah. It's a shame that the French government don't take an interest in these houses. A real shame. Because this is such a... And the town too. I mean, there's nothing really in this town. I'll tell you, there's nothing in this town. My apologies to the residents there, but there's not much. This is the jewel in the crown. It should be saved. It should be saved. This would bring tourists to the area if they knew about it. Restore it, open it as a bed and breakfast, spend the tax money on something sensible instead of weapons and stuff. See the computer screen there? The old lady must have been monitoring the security cameras from there, and maybe she called the police as soon as someone was breaking in. The young lady here thinks that the woman must have slept in here. This is the most stable room, doesn't smell damp, she was saying. So this was obviously her nerve center where she slept. Must have been terrifying for her, because I'm sure people were trying to break in. Hopefully the police were responsive and got there in time. Don't know the full story. I do know that someone said, as I say, she's in an old person's home now. Don't know what's going to happen to this place. Whether it'll go under some legal battle. And someone else mentioned that the son of the owner, the son of the lady, lives in Paris. So I don't know what's going to be happening. There's where we were, outside there, parked in that car park. Yeah. Wondering what was inside. Devastation reigns. Look at that. Look at the roof. Oh, my goodness. Yeah, they're going to cost a lot. I don't even know if it could be fixed. I'm not an expert on these things. But something needs to be done before it's too far gone. Some wonderful religious statuary. Yeah, I could fix that probably. I reckon I could fix that. Look at the beautiful stained glass window, and it hasn't been smashed. Ugh, it's amazing. And the staircase is fantastic. Fantastic. Look at that. Someone's been rifling through the place. Some old patriotic pictures there, prints. My cat is outside the door meowing like crazy. I've locked her out. Otherwise, you wouldn't be able to hear me speak. Yeah. Overall, there must have been water dripping all through the top floor. And you see some of the floor has collapsed there. Well, you wouldn't want to be sleepwalking, would you? You'd end up on the bottom floor. And he's been he's treading gingerly here. Obviously, the floor is mushy. Yeah, I don't blame you, mate. There we go. Some old books. Enough to read if you were to stay the night there. It's an old radiogram. Imagine that, you sleepwalking. Suddenly you plummet about two stories. That'll be my luck. Now look at the sort of shrine cabinet there. Reminiscent of the one on that junk shop tour that I did with the statue of Jesus in it. Very similar, isn't it? Yeah, look at that. Yeah, it would cost a pretty penny to fix this place up again. So the young guy was saying that in his original commentary that the person had, this lady had placed buckets everywhere and tubes. She was obviously trying to divert the water back outside again. There must have been so much coming through. Unfortunately, it didn't seem to work, did it? Looking at the devastation throughout. See the tube there going right out. She was obviously trying to get the water out. It must have been just pouring down. When it was raining, the whole place must have been just raining upstairs. There's a British flag. Now, so this seems to be the attic space. And, not much up here. But the roof seems pretty much intact, that part, didn't it? Some old military uniforms there. Sort of moth-eaten, which is understandable. And then look at these old documents relating to the chateau from 1894. I mean, this is really historic stuff. This should be saved. This should be saved. People of the town of Bayonne, if any of you are watching that, go to your mayor. Speak to him. Talk about saving this place. Something needs to be done. Something needs to be done. Before it's too late, if it's not too late already. This young lady here is picking up a photo, which we presume is a photo of the the last inhabitant, this lady, the hoarder. That's her there. Well, my dear viewers, I hope you've enjoyed that tour, courtesy of Bob. Thank you so much, Bob. It was a real treat to see that. And we finally got in, my dear viewers. We finally got in to see the Enchanted Chateau. Anyway, my dear viewers, the very next tour is of this amazing French chateau where we stayed overnight. This chateau is intact inside, and we stayed there and we explored it. And it is indeed a time capsule. It's a real time capsule. So that's something to look forward to. But before that, the very next video will be the Halloween special. So stay tuned for that. And I'll put the link to Bob's channel in the description. Also, I'll link it on the end screen. So thank you for watching and take care. God bless. Bye-bye.